Alright, welcome to Chicagoland Speedway. We're here tonight with Bigdawgz Racing, Bigdawgz Gaming. Check them out, Bigdawgzgaming.com, I believe it is. And I tell you, they're into all sorts of gaming activities, not just racing. But tonight, it's all about racing. Chicagoland Speedway, we got 10 of the best from Bigdawgz here tonight. Jeff Ward, Gary Warren, they're all here. Chad Williams, the whole group working the booth with me tonight. None other than Matthew Close, Dakota Ehrman. He'll be calling the action from pit road here tonight from Chicagoland Speedway. Matthew, Chicagoland Speedway, let's talk about this track here for a minute. 1 mile track, 5 degree banking along the back stretch, 11 degrees down the front stretch. So this isn't, there's no flat place on this track anywhere.
No, dude, it's never really straight either. I mean, we got to think that backstretch has the curve all the way down it, and the front stretch has even more banking in the backstretch and even a bigger curve. Man, at this track, you're always turning left.
You know, and as big as this track is, it's a very peculiar track. The turns on both ends of the track are not the same. It's a D-shaped oval, but I guarantee you, when you come down the front stretch going into turn one, it doesn't have the same feel at all as you do going into turns three and four. Turns three and four have a little bit tighter radius on it. Turn one and two, real wide. It'll take you right up to the wall if you're not careful, but then you got to keep some left-hand pressure on it because the backstretch isn't straight either.
No, and you got to think, coming into turn one, that front stretch is just so angled. You're already halfway angled in to rotate that center of the turn, and just heading into three, you're almost ready to run your car straight up into that wall, JD. Here, you got to think, it's a lot like Michigan, too. You get on that lower groove, there's a lot of bumps down there.
Yeah, and you know, the other peculiar thing about this track, it's one of the few 1 mile tracks, I guess you could call it, or a 1.5 mile track. There's a whole lot of draft here at Chicagoland Speedway. Going down that front stretch, you're probably going to get close to speeds approaching 200 miles an hour going off into turn one. And at this track, Chicagoland, you can go all the way to the grass here coming down the front stretch. But there is a trick. If you do get down there, the cross that white line down there on that apron, it is flat. So you have to make that transition. If you do get down there, and of course, you got to transition back up. I've seen a lot of cars go for an e-ticket ride, you know, trying to make a few extra seconds on a lap by, you know, a few tenths of a second by taking that fast course down there by the grass. But pushing the buttons on the camera for you tonight, as always, we call him Magic Fingers back at the office. I tell you what, everybody else calls him the bad boy, John Wessling, on the cameras here at Chicagoland Speedway. But I tell you what, let's take him down through the points here a little bit and let him know who's who and who's where here with Bigdawgz Gaming. And starting out at the top, Jeff Ward, I tell you what, he's got eight wins, five top fives, 10 top tens. Jeff Ward, the leader of the pack here at Bigdawgz Gaming. And Chad Williams, who sits second here. He finished fourth at Richmond last week. Jeff Ward, of course, taking the trophy home at Richmond last week. Chad sits 22 points behind the leader. Now, Chad's got an impressive top five count, 14 of them, a couple of wins, and three top tens. I'll tell you, his effort coming home with top fives quite a bit here is what's keeping him up here in the points. Sitting in third position, up a position this week, Jesse Richardson. Jesse is 77 points off the leader. He has 18 starts here. He's got a couple of poles to his credit. He's taken a trophy home here at Bigdawgz Racing with a win. He's got five top fives, and he also has 12 top tens as well. So he is absolutely a contender. And I believe this is Jeff Ward's brother, Mike Ward. He's up a notch this week. He sits in fourth position, finished 11th at Richmond last week. And I forgot to mention Jesse Richardson, second place finish at Richmond last week. Mike Ward sits 107 points behind the leader, Matt. And he's got three top fives, 11 top tens, so a solid performer there. And sitting right here in the middle, down a couple of notches this week, Gary Warren in fifth place, 115 off the lead. He's got a win. He has eight top five finishes. Solid performance there with five top tens.
Yeah, back in second points, we've got Dwayne Hamm. It doesn't look like he's made an entrance into tonight's race yet, but he's sitting 143 points back, five top fives and seven top tens, but it looks like he might drop a few spots here in the points, not showing up tonight. The next guy you've got in seventh place in points, Scott Saul, 174 points back. He finished ninth at Richmond last week. He has zero wins this season, two top fives, and you got nine top tens for him. He looks to be very competitive here tonight. He might be going out to get his first win so far for this season. Back in eighth, you've got Anthony Colantoni. He did not make a start at Richmond. He's 273 points back with one win this season, six top fives, and two top tens. Just going to take you real quick here through ninth and tenth. You've got Kevin Buchanan. He's 289 back. And then you've got Patrick Miguel Louis, who's 303 points back.
You bet. And that's going to be Anthony Colantoni. Unusual for Anthony not to be here tonight. Colantoni usually shows up at these races. And then, of course, Patrick McKelvey down there at the bottom in 10th position. 10 drivers, actually 11 drivers. So we got a latecomer here tonight. But 11 drivers tonight. Jeff Ward sits on the pole. Gary Warren, he'll be outside him on the front row up there. And tell you what, lickety split around Chicagoland Speedway here. Jeff Ward posted a 30.499 here at Chicago to get the pole here tonight. So sitting here during happy hour watching practice session here, guys. I know Dakota has spent some time in the garage here talking to some of these guys. Dakota, hearing anything down there? Any strategies? What are we looking for here tonight?
I'll tell you what, JD, tonight is going to be one of the most interesting nights we've seen in quite a while. The fuel game is so small in a way that it's going to cause guys to go down pit road at least five times, if not more. You can only get to about 15 to 18 laps on the fuel game is what these guys are saying, and they're really, really loose off the corner. I was talking to Jeff Ward, who you guys were mentioning is the points leader. He says he's really good at the mile and a half. They're probably one of his favorite tracks, and that's where he's planning to shine tonight, as he did get in late and still managed to snatch the pole. I also talked to Chad Williams, who was second in points, and Chad also saying he likes his track, but he was much more confident with Jeff not here. So it's going to be interesting tonight, but usually you're going to see four tires because these guys are really loose off. I don't know that strategy is going to play too much into it, though.
All right. Good stuff coming from Dakota Ehrman down around pit road. Of course, Dakota Ehrman, one of the best here at ETV Live. And I tell you, Chicagoland Speedway, a mile and a half track. This has always been one of my favorite tracks to drive, but this is not one of those things you just put it on cruise control and just cruise, Matthew Close. You really got to drive this track, especially when you got the turns on both ends of the track, different configurations, different radius. And turn three, always been my problem here. You're coming down that backstretch. You got to get off kind of early and get that thing nosed in. Now, there are two distinct grooves here at Chicagoland Speedway, so look for drivers coming through turns three using that high line, as well as some using the bottom. But here's a little trick, guys. Using that bottom down there, probably going to get beat by the guy on the top, because you got to really back off the throttle and wait a little bit before you get back on because of that tight radius on the bottom. But right now, I tell you what, I hear the Cactus Cooties down trackside getting warmed up. Why don't we go down and take it to them for our national anthem?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly bursting in air.
All right, and thank you to the Cactus Cooties for about the most wonderful rendition of the national anthem that I have ever heard. Those young ladies are ages 11 to 16, four of them. You can check them out at cactuscuties.com. And, boy, beautiful voices down there. And it looks like we're about ready to take the grid here, guys, here just momentarily. And we're looking at 100 laps here at Chicagoland Speedway. Jeff Ward has the pole here tonight. He'll be driving that Mossy Oak number 89 machine. Starting on the second row in the 66 car, Gary Warren on the outside. Gentlemen. Back on the inside in the third position back here. Second row, Jesse Richardson in that 7F machine. Chad Williams, he'll be driving that number 31 machine in fourth position on the outside in the second row. In the third row, Norman Rodriguez in a number 74 car on the inside in fifth position. Outside him in sixth will be Gary Wilson. As soon as he gets fired up and moved out of the garage here. In seventh position, the 101 car being driven by Scott Zoll on the outside of him. In eighth position, in the 21 car, Patrick McElwee. Nelson Rodriguez will be driving the 78 machine in ninth position on the inside. Starting outside of him in 10th position, the number 82 of Nick Grome. Lee Dietz, he'll be right shotgun on the field here on the start, starting 11th in that 83 car all the way in the back. So he's got 10 positions to make up. As looks like we get some kind of a miscue here. All right, we'll stay with the action here. It looks like race administrators have decided to go ahead and restart the game, the race here. Apparently they didn't like what they saw from the get-go.
Yeah, JD, and they said they're doing this just to give that driver another chance to get his car fired up and on the grid in time.
Yeah, I know race officials, they only give you so much time to move your car from the garage out onto the grid out here on pit road. And if you miss it, they go ahead and start the race and lock the gate. So apparently I think it was the 82 machine, or no, I believe it was the 78 car was still back in the garage the first time around. So they decided to go ahead and repost it, open up the gate, let everybody back out, and we're going to go here again. And again, quickly down the list here, Jeff Ward on the pole outside him, Gary Warren, Jesse Richardson starting on the inside, second row, Chad Williams on the outside, third row, Norman Rodriguez and Gary Wilson, and the fourth row is going to be Scott Zoll and Patrick McElwee on the outside, in the fifth row, Nelson Rodriguez and Nick Gromes. And Lee Dietz will be starting shotgun on the field all the way to the back here. 100 laps at Chicagoland Motor Speedway with 11 drivers. This should be a pretty decent race here tonight. However, it don't make any difference if there's one car or 100 cars on this track, Matt. You've still got to drive this track, before you start racing the competition. So we'll see what these boys have here tonight for 100 laps at Chicagoland. Pace car is pulling off. Jeff Ward setting up, picking up that green flag. The 66 car up on the outside. Gary Warren, as we come to the start.
Green, 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 green.
The flag is in the air, and we are green flag racing at Chicagoland Speedway here tonight. 100 laps on the board, and we're 2x2 here all the way back to about fifth position. Gary Wilson up on the top side. Rodriguez going past him off of turn two. Down the back stretch. Now remember, backstretch is not straight. You've got to keep a little left-hand pressure on it all the way into turn three. So that throws some people off sometimes, but it looks like a good start coming back through turns three and four. Oh, Warren all the way up to the wall has to really get off the throttle. That's going to put Jeff Ward all the way out front, crossing the start-finish line. First lap in the books here as Gary Warren going backwards.
Yeah, JD, I thought we were going to see right what you were talking about on that first lap. I thought Jeff Ward, our pole sitter, in trouble on that inside. I thought We were just going to see Gary Warren get that high line run. Man, he just drove it way too hard. And that's that three push I was talking about. It's not as curved as going into one. You really got to let off, like you said.
It's always been my experience here that turn three is a real trick here. Turn one, it's kind of a no-brainer. You just tuck it down to that white line, keep it down there for a little while, let her drift on up to the wall because it's a long ways from that apron line all the way up to that outside wall. So you go ahead and let her drift like you see the number seven machine doing right now. Let it slide on out. But Jeff Ward's got a big run on Richardson coming off the bottom there. Gary Warren back here in third position in that 66 Mossy Oak machine. Nice looking car.
Yeah, and that number seven looked like he had a nice low line through there, but he got a little bit loose. We talked about those bumps. They're just like running around Michigan. You get to that bottom line, your car's all over the place, splitter banging off the ground, and your car just wants to go up the track on you. But that looks like that number seven of Jesse Richardson going to make a move on the inside coming out of two.
Pressure building up here in front. Jesse Richardson going past Ward for the lead up here down the backstretch. And here comes Gary Warren. Slides his car through. He's going to take that turn real wide. Oh! Seven car in trouble. Tags the wall. Jesse Richardson in trouble, guys. Going through turns three and four. Goes all the way to the wall and takes a souvenir from him. And almost take Gromes out here in the process. Right, oh, we got one spinning out. Caution out on track for the first time.
Yeah, and that's Norman Rodriguez. Just drove it hard into turn one. He was trying to get a run on that inside, and he just, when he hit the brakes, there must be too much rear brake bias in that car, and he spun it right out.
Yeah, I'm rolling it up here now. Take a look at it here. And Norman Rodriguez back here in 11th position.
Get roads closed.
And you're absolutely right, it's all by himself, just going a little bit too deep, too hard, back end breaks loose, around she goes. Tags a wall here quite a bit, but I tell you what, they'll get it down on pit road, pull that sheet metal out as we watch him in slow motion on the replay here, and he grabs that souvenir off the outside wall. But first caution here at Chicagoland Speedway.
Yeah, JD, this really could be a miracle for that 89 Jeff Ward. We saw him sliding back in a hurry after qualifying on, I believe, the pole position here. So maybe his crew's going to come down and throw a few wrenches in that rear window or not. I mean, maybe he had a few bad starts. He was really overdriving the car, it looked like, at the beginning here, and that's the last thing you want to do at a track like Chicago.
Okay, pits are up for all cars. We can pit now.
Yeah, you know, like I said, this is a track, no matter how many cars there are on this track, Chicago is kind of a peculiar track. It's not like the other mile-and-a-half tracks, the Atlantas, the Texas, places like that. This is a pretty peculiar track. You really got to drive this track. There's a huge draft effect going down the front stretch and the back stretch here. I felt it even more so at this track than I have, say, at the Atlantas and Texas, the typical tribal-shaped tracks. But pit road is open, and they're all coming down. Of course, Mark Martin, hey, it's going to be four new shoes and a bucket of O's for me too, Cowboy. Why don't we go ahead and step away? Let's take our first commercial break. You're watching live, ETV Live, Cowboy. Chicagoland Speedway with Bigdawgz Racing. We'll be right back. All right, and we are back live here at Chicagoland Speedway, working our first caution here. We just got the one to go from the race officials here. Happened on lap 5, 74 machine of Norman Rodriguez bringing the back end around on his machine. And as he spun it out there, and looks like he's actually back down pit road again to get some more repairs on that machine. But Dakota, you know, let's take it down to pit road here just a minute. You know, everybody came down pit road that time, only 5 laps in. I think I would probably roll the dice and stayed out. What do you think?
I mean, you want to come down and get those tires as soon as you can. I'm listening on the radio, some of these drivers, like Gary Warren, he just basically snuck away with the lead. He was complaining that his car was so tight in the corner entry, but his car was just so loose off, and a lot of draft lane. And I mean, the faster you're going in the draft, the more you're burning up these tires, and you really don't want to do that. Plus the fact that the faster you're going, it's going to be handling a lot different than what you were in practice if you're running by yourself. So I mean, they're probably burning the tires up a lot more than what they actually thought they would be, and so I would actually be coming down and getting 4 every time.
There you go. You know, I've always been a Mark Martin fan too. It'd be 4 new shoes and a bucket of oats for me every time I got a chance. But picking up the green flag, Gary Warren. Of course, he went to the front here before that.
Green.
Patrick McKelley restarting second. Chad Williams right on his bumper here. Jeff Ward, who started on the pole here, and went south early here in the race. He's hanging out here up on the top in that 89 machine. Of course, he just might be waiting it out here as we put 8 laps in the books here at Chicagoland Speedway. Nick Grom's in 5th position back here in that 82 machine. Single file, guys, pretty much until you get to the 8th position. No, Jesse Richardson hanging the wall. He's going around. No caution. Richardson in the wall as he tries to peel it off and keep it straight here. Oh, caution's going to come out here, guys.
Back it down.
Caution's going to come out for the
just took the yellow.
For Jesse Richardson here, guys, in that number 7 machine.
Yeah, JD, I can't help but think that they're going to tell him he needs to pull that in. It's the second time he's done this, and I'm guessing that time it was just lingering damage from his first accident, but I don't think he's going to have any chance of repairing that this time.
Yeah, just pulling it back up here on the rewind here a little bit, watching him. And he just breaks it loose and then slides it up into the wall here a little bit, gets a piece of the action. Trying to peel it off the wall is a real trick, guys. There's almost like a magnet effect. It kind of keeps you sucked into that wall up there. And you just got to keep cranking on the wheel. Get off the throttle and hope she peels off the wall. But Richardson in big trouble here at Chicagoland tonight for the second caution here, guys. So the 7 and the 74 car bringing out the caution here tonight within the first 10 laps at Chicagoland Speedway. And again, this is not the easiest track to drive. You know, you got to drive this track before you start taking on a competition. And
okay, pits are up for all cars.
Maybe these guys are just putting a little bit too much, you know, just counting on their car a little bit too much too early here. If it was me, I think I'd probably give it 4 or 5 laps. And I know from experience in racing this particular mod, this particular game, that, you know, you have to get your tires up to speed. You just can't go out there after a pit stop and think you're just going to get after everything. It don't work that way. This is like doing the real deal.
Okay.
You got to heat those tires up.
Yeah, JD, I actually went back and I looked at that a couple extra times. I mean, you got to think. They added the safer barriers in on all these NASCAR tracks now, and we can see it in this game. And it looks like where at this track, it's not even around. It sticks out a little bit when you're going into turn 3 a little bit more than in turn 1. You don't notice it so much. But it looks like he might have just caught it the way it came out at him. He didn't realize it poked out that much.
Dude, Darlington Speedway. How many times have I hit that little thing that juts out right there with the safer barrier right at the end of turn, at the end of the backstretch? I think I've caved in the front right side of my car, you know, about 10 times. And the same thing here. You're absolutely right, Matt. That little piece of that safer barrier sticks out. And... you know, it's just, it sticks out there. It's like a boulder sticking out of there.
Yeah, and I mean, I plenty of times too. I know exactly what you're talking. It's easy because he was almost tucked up right behind somebody, and you lose track, and you're like, "Hey, I'm gonna gun it to that outside man." You just lose track of that wall coming up.
Yeah, and then pow. But looks like they've. I've heard the announcer say they've got one to go. So when the pace car is pulling off here, Patrick McGilley out in front now. Jeff Ward working his way back up to the front here. Remember, he started out on the pole, but McKelvey going to pick up the green flag. Nick Brown back there in third. Wilson and Dietz. Dietz all the way up into fifth position here on the restart as we go motoring off into turn one. Now, here we go. All right. This is the key part right here. Get three or four laps under your belt here, Cowboy, before you cut them ponies loose and let them feel the road here a little bit and then start getting after it. But usually it turns into a single file race here for quite some time. Until you get them tires up to 10th. Zoll in ninth position back there up on the outside, trying to make that outside groove work for him. And like I said, Matt, you'll see a couple of distinct racing grooves here in Chicagoland here tonight.
Well, JD, actually on in this race, I've been seeing a lot of three grooves, man. These guys going three wide all the time. Not Ken. They're going to do it right here, the 31, the 66. Back here, I believe that is the 74 Norman Rodriguez back on the outside. He's already been in trouble tonight, but he's not afraid. He's going to stick his nose right into all that trouble.
And the 74 down on the bottom of the 83 here as the 83 comes down. Oh, they're touching door handles here a little bit. That's going to be Rodriguez and Dietz back here, eighth position. But it's like Dietz is going to get the run on Rodriguez because Rodriguez was involved in that first caution back on lap five. So I tell you what, 14 laps in the books here at Chicagoland Speedway with 11 drivers. I think I'd be just putting this thing on cruise control here for about 80 laps, and I'd see what I could come up with the last 20. But I tell you, these boys are getting after it right here pretty early. Moving up to fifth position, Gary Warren. Looks like he's going past the 27 machine of Wilson. Wilson up on the outside. Going into turn one, off turn two, down the back stretch. Williams is going to get the run on the 27 as well. So Gary Wilson moving back here to the sixth position.
I mean, looking at Gary Wilson, he's doing exactly what you talked about. Long race, 10, 11 cars in the race tonight. I mean, he's got that thing on cruise control. He's running his line. He doesn't want anybody to bother him. But now we're looking back at the fourth and fifth position as Chad Williams. Looks like he's going to try and work over that 66 to Gary Warren. Looking to try and see what line he's got to use to get around him. He's poking his nose to the outside here. It looks like he's going to try and get a run down the back stretch, maybe try an inside move into three.
You bet. And in the meantime, I've been watching Nick Gromes up here in third position, guys. He's staying off that apron line down there all the way around the track. You know, this is what I would expect out of these guys. He's been pretty much following the same groove all the way around. You can see him running that center groove going through turn one. He's going to come off of turn two here down the back stretch. Now, when he gets down into turn three, he'll stay right in that middle groove here a little bit and bend it on around through turn four. And then he keeps his car pretty steady. Well, now see, he's going to fool me this time. He takes it down to the apron line, but... last couple of times around, he's been staying in that middle groove all the way around the track.
Yeah, well, JD, now he's got company for that position. The 66 of Gary Warren, the 31 of Chad Williams. Chad Williams actually going to take advantage of the going back and block, and we actually got a caution on the track.
And it's going to be Gary Wilson, guys. Wilson bringing that caution out. Yeah, it's going to be the 27 machine here. Roll around here and see what happened. Looks like same deal, guys. Loose conditions. Dakota's been talking about it all night from pit road down there. Wilson's going to get loose coming off of I believe that's turn three, if I'm not mistaken. Going to grab a piece of the wall as we see him rolling just ever so slowly. And then you'll see the back end tag the wall here a little bit. And then grab his souvenir. But third caution here at Chicagoland Speedway, 19 laps in the books. Dakota, what's the strategy? Four tires and a tank of gas?
Yeah, right now I'm thinking you're going to see most guys come in and get four tires of fuel. There were a few guys that actually came back down that last time, like Gary Warren, who was the current leader. But quite a few guys actually stayed out. Gary was able to work his way back up through the field mainly, but I think staying out worked out last time with maybe a 2 or 3 lap run on the tires. Not much, but this time you're going to see just about everybody come down. And an update on the 17 or 27 and who it is, I believe they have a left rear tire actually down.
Hey Dakota, just another quick question for you tonight, and I mean, I know we're only a 100 lap race, I'm thinking one stop, but can you confirm that for me? How many laps do you think we can go here on a tank of gas?
As I said earlier, I was talking to most of the drivers and crew chiefs, and they actually only estimate about 15 to 18 laps in the fuel run, so not many laps that you can make here.
Alright, working the third caution here tonight, guys. And one of the reasons why they're only going to get that many laps, they've got fuel and tire set on what they call 2X here, so kind of throws a kink in the works here a little bit. They want you to get in, get some pit stops. I mean, that's all part of the strategy too, as we watch the action coming off pit road. Looks like Patrick McGilvey, actually I'm going to have to roll that one back. I don't know if McGilvey beat Ward off or not here. Ward's got that first box up there starting on the pole. It looks like Ward's going to beat McGilvey off after all. It looks like it's going to put Jeff Ward back out in front. Patrick McGilvey will be starting second. Gary Warren being shown in third, Nick Grom's being shown fourth, Chad Williams in fifth for your top five on this restart. I'll take a minute and tell you about ETV Live Radio. I'll tell you what, Cowboy, always pushing the bar. We are proud to introduce ETV Live Radio, supported by HD Radio Network. ETV Live Radio features classic rock every hour, every day. You can also catch live events, just like the one we're broadcasting here tonight, such as Race Day broadcast right from the booth, Open Paddock Live at 9:30 p.m. on Tuesday nights, the Pit Report on Friday nights, and I'll tell you what, Wesley Atlin and Michael Neff on Monday nights from 6 to 8 p.m. And the winner is Motorsports Show, all right here on ETV Live Radio. And I tell you what, if you're into the classic rock, 24/7 Cowboy, until we go live with one of our syndicated shows or a race broadcast right from the booth here at ETV Live. So enjoy the ETV Live Radio. You can get to it right there on the front of the website. We're also listed on iTunes, TuneIn.com, and listed on the Windows Media Guide. So, Dakota, you've got a radio show coming up tomorrow, the Pit Report.
Sir, and don't forget to tune in. I believe we'll have a few special guests, David Lanza included, who was the winner at Real Sim Racing last Monday night.
Got David Lanza picking up the trophy. I believe that's his second win in a row, if I'm not mistaken. I'd have to go back and look through the record books. But David Lanza, you're right, winning at Richmond last week at Real Sim Racing on Monday night. And a few other guests as well lined up. Unfortunately, I won't be there. I've got an appointment that I've got to keep. Can't miss it. But Dakota, he'll be taking on a show here tomorrow night. Of course, Dakota and I usually do it together. But we kind of swap back and forth when one of us got something to do. So
pace cars off, coming to the green flag this time by
green, 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 green.
Taking the green, Jeff Ward out in front, Patrick McGilvey in second, Gary Warren third. You got Nick Gromes in fourth and fifth. Chad Williams at number 31 as they're heading hard down into turn one.
Turn one it is, and they're all taking a piece of that apron line with them down there, right down there at the bottom, let it drift up to the top. And, you know, every time I've raced this track, the first few times, you really get kind of jittery coming off of turn two. That wall does come up pretty fast when you get that slingshot effect off turn one. But you come around those two turns, and you just got to trust the car, trust your setup, trust your steering wheel, and just let it drift. And just do a little bit to stay off that wall. Of course, you're going to have a little left-hand pressure all the way around this track anyway, because there's not a straight piece on this track. So you're always very aware of what's going on. And also, consequently, Chicago has been, it's been a kind of a tire eater at times, too, up here in third position, Patrick McElwee up on the top. You've got Gary Warren on the bottom coming down the front stretch up here. McElwee trying to make that top side work for position. Warren able to stay in the throttle just a little bit longer in that middle groove. He can slide right up in front of McElwee, but here comes the 31 alongside as we battle for position back here in fourth.
Yeah, JD, and there's a lot of guys up in the mix right there. I mean, you've got the attitude, the 82 of Nick Grohm just sitting right there, stalking that battle right now. Maybe he's just on cruise control, but like you said, I saw that when you talked about the aggressive move, them taking the piece of the apron, first lap coming back to green, that surprised me, because like you said, we really don't want to be doing that on fresh tires here.
You bet, and I want to throw a shout-out to Dwayne Hamm. Dwayne Hamm not able to make the grid here tonight. He's feeling a little bit under the weather here, but I know he probably wished he could be here. He usually helped me out with the prep work doing the broadcast for Bigdawgz Racing here. Bigdawgzgaming.com. You got to check these guys out. It's not just racing, but they're into a lot of stuff. Oh, Williams off the track down on the apron here. Comes through turn two. That was back here in fifth position, but he's able to gather it up and put it back up on the track, almost losing it. But I tell you, bigdawgzgaming.com, they've got some battlefield stuff going on. I mean, it's just it's like a little gaming community here. You got to check these guys out, bigdawgzgaming.com. 27 laps in the books here at Chicagoland Speedway. And Mug Rodriguez in the number nine, or in ninth position back here going around. That's going to be Norman Rodriguez again in that 74 car, guys. Caution back out here. And that's the same deal as last time, almost the same exact place.
Pit road's
back in,
pit
road's comes
closed.
Around. And gets that e-ticket ride into the outside wall. We'll pull it up on the ETV Live exclusive e-wind and see if we can take a look at the 74 car as he comes around the turn. You can see him getting a good run in, but just a little bit too much throttle coming off, or maybe a little bit too hard going in. Watch that back end start coming around, tag the back wall, the outside wall, and of course pick up another souvenir. So caution number four here at Chicago.
Yeah, JD, and that 74 Norman Rodriguez and the number 7 of Jesse Richardson definitely making the paint guys' job hard tonight. Going to repaint all these walls around here by the end, it looks like. Both those guys in the wall numerous times.
Pits are open for lead cars only. Lead cars only.
You bet. And, you know, we've been talking about Chicagoland Speedway. I mean, it's kind of a tough track here. I mean, guys were talking about loose conditions all night here tonight. So, you know, and this is where it pays to practice as they all come down pit road. You know, practice laps mean everything. You find out what your car can do, what it can't do. You know, you discover what its limits are, really, as they come down pit road. Let's take it on down to Dakota Irwin. Dakota, what are you hearing down there, bud?
Several four-tire calls. I believe that's going to be all you're going to be seeing is mostly four-tire stops and filling it up with fuel just so they can make it to another stop.
And, of course, the 74 machine of Norman Rodriguez, probably going to be an extended pit stop for him down there in that sixth position back there on pit road. They got a ton of sheet metal they got to pull away from the wheels down there. So Rodriguez will undoubtedly start in the back of the pack here tonight. But unfortunate for that 74 machine. Now that's a couple of times he's already gotten in a wall here tonight. So imagine the crew chief pulling his hair out, reminding that driver just to kind of stay off the throttle just a little bit more.
Yeah, I mean, I think we're going to just keep seeing it. These guys are overdrive cars, and they're overdriving them early. They're not giving the chance for them to really set into the track here. And
pit now.
That's what you need is, I mean, you give these guys probably, if they could actually do an 8-10 lap run, they're going to tighten those cars up, and they're actually going to run each other as hard as they want to, but they're not giving themselves the chance to wear out those tires a little bit and get them maybe stick a little bit better to the track.
You bet. And I don't know about you guys, but I, if you're staying in the same cheap-ass motel that John got us all here in Chicagoland, dude, I tell you what a flea-ridden bag that I'm staying in. But I tell you what, we're camped out here at Chicagoland Speedway for the next few days. Tomorrow night, Friday night showdown. You don't want to miss this action, Cowboy. Some pretty good racing there. Friday night showdown with Michael Conte and the boys. Dakota Herman will be along. And then Saturday, get the beer cooler out, fill it up, get a couple of bags of chip and some dip and some good eats. We're broadcasting Nuff World's race from Chicagoland Speedway. That's a full-on 100%, I believe it's 400 miles, or 400 laps, if I'm not mistaken. Or 300, or what is it, about 900 laps we're doing tomorrow, John? Or John can't talk to us anymore, but Dakota?
I couldn't even tell you.
Oh, no, Dakota's standing back there at the buffet table anyway. But anyway, Saturday at 8 o'clock here on ETV Live, you can check it out. We'll be broadcasting from Chicagoland Speedway, the Nuff World race. And then on Sunday at about the same time, about 7:45 p.m., the SCE Elite Pro Series from Chicagoland Speedway. So camped out here at Chicagoland for the whole entire week. Can't wait to get out of here. I guess the ETV Live window bag was in the shop. Maybe that's why I got this flea bag motel room.
Yeah, JD, I ain't too happy with mine either, but I guess it's what we got for this weekend. Glad to be out here with these guys, though, still doing what we do best.
You bet. And we just got the one to go from race officials, so pace car will take them back around one more time. And probably be a good time to talk to you about Stock Car Evolution 2012. Brings intensity, the grit, and the roaring sound of NASCAR to the PC via R-Factor. SCE 2012 is scratch-built stock car simulator mod for R-Factor. It's been in development since 2005. I'm pretty familiar with it, and I know the manufacturers personally. And I'll tell you what, it's a highly detailed racing simulation game. New levels of detail in both the physics and graphics. And I'll tell you, it's a thrilling racing action game, and the realism that hardcore fans really appreciate. StockCarEvolution.com. You can check it out over there. And like their tagline, do you have what it takes? Well, you can find out. StockCarEvolution.com. And their race is coming up here on Sunday night at 7:45. And this time around, Patrick McElwee is going to pick up the green flag here tonight. Jeff Ward, our pole sitter, riding behind. Jeff Ward's spending a lot of time up here in front, just not on the front row up here.
Green flag, go!
Green flag is out. McElwee, Ward, and Warren, the top three. Chad Williams in fourth position back here. Chad hanging out in the top five here quite a bit as well. Warren putting the pressure on the outside. Ward on the bottom. That 89 machine looks like he's going to give a little bit up to that 90s or the 66 car, as Gary Warren's going to get to position over the 89. 89 actually losing a couple of positions. Chad Williams comes along on the outside and picks up third place.
Yeah, it just looks like Jeff Ward didn't pick up the throttle coming out of turn two there. Got freight train down the back stretch. 31 though, Chad Williams showing strong all night, starting to work his way up towards the front. You got Miguel, we out front, and he actually touches the 66 of Gary Warren. Gary Warren on the outside.
Three wide.
Chad Williams, three wide.
Three wide, down the backstretch, 21 in the middle. Warren up on the top. Chad Williams on the bottom here as we go into turn three, guys. And Gary Warren just putting that 66 car in that middle groove, making that top line run up here. Chad Williams moves back a notch. But the 21 machine of Patrick McElwee taking the three wide. Here comes the 89, Jeff Ward, the pole sitter on the bottom. Down the front stretch.
Yeah, and these guys not giving any time, like I said, for their cars to settle in, going right at each other. I'm sure not too much longer we'll see another person make an overdriven mistake. But the 31, Chad Williams, a little bit slower in the 3, but he's going to get that runoff 4. It looks like actually catches the apron a little bit, losing ground.
Roughly. All right, and roughly 65 laps left of the books here at Chicagoland Speedway, but Nelson Rodriguez, 11th place back here. Guys, tire down on the machine as he makes his way down pit road. You can see it smoking. I'm going to roll it back and on my replay here and see if I can figure out what happened to that 78 car.
Actually, I got it up already, and that 78 car, man, he just lost it, like I said, they were going to tonight. Overdriving his car, he slammed it into turn the walls in turn one and two and put that fender right through the tire. I think that's going to end the night for Nelson Rodriguez.
Yeah, I'm watching it too. He's right there with Dietz, and same thing we've been seeing all night, guys. Right here in turn one, it just breaks loose. A little bit too hard going in, you know. I mean, you got to get off the throttle a little bit sooner. Just let that car ride around. But obviously gets loose on him, and away it goes. No caution, however. Gary Warren still out in front with Chad Williams and crew chasing him down.
Yeah, and Ward's really made up a lot of time since that incident on the restart here. He's pulled his gap down to about 0.3 seconds within the leader. It looks like he may lose a few tenths this time by he had a few slip-ups in turn one and turn three. But he's about to start making moves on that 31 of Chad Williams for second place. It looks like they're all settling in here up front.
You bet, and I tell you, they're just keeping the pressure on that 66 machine pretty good here. But, you know, still a ton of laps left to go here at Chicagoland. I'm still on cruise control if it was me. And these turns here, you know, especially coming through turns one and two. I know we've talked about turns three and four and how, you know, what the trick is there, but one and two, you got to let the car roll. You just can't go in there too deep. I mean, that big old wide track, it is wide. However, that doesn't mean you can stay in the throttle, that much longer. This is the kind of track where you got to let your car rotate through the turn. You just got to let it roll. And, you think you're going to get back on the throttle, just take a count of one, two, and then get back on the throttle. You can probably save yourself a lot of headache. But, this isn't like the Atlantas and Texas mile and a half. Oh, almost going three wide here. I'll say Warren had kind of a slip up there, but Williams going to take the lead here. Chad Williams to the front here. Looked like Warren may have slipped up there just a little bit.
Yep, and he pushes it almost three wide coming out of turn four. Warren putting the 21 in the wall, just running him out of room, putting him in that high side wall, coming out of four. 21 can't be too happy about that. And I just mean that 89, Jeff Ward, moving forward again, trying to pick up that third position and move up maybe past that 66 of Gary Warren.
You bet, as we saw it on the exclusive E-Wine there. And now it's Chad Williams, Gary Warren, Patrick McGelly up in front. But I tell you, these guys are just absolutely duking it out up here in the front. Let's take it back a couple of notches back to fifth position. Lee Dietz running by himself back here, no help. And then in sixth position is going to be Nick Groms. Nick without any help either, kind of running by himself. Sixth position occupied by that 82 machine, or actually seventh position occupied by that 101 machine of Scott Zoll. Scott back here by himself too, so quite a bit of distance between the last few cars here in line. But then here again, you know, cruise control. Still a lot of laps left to go here, not even at the halfway point at Chicago. So I'd just be kind of riding around. I don't want to let those leaders get too far out in front of me, but I'm sure there's probably going to be one or two more cautions yet to come. I know I probably got at least a couple more pit stops to go, as Zoll almost loses it coming off of turn two.
I'll tell you one driver that's not on cruise control, and that's Miguel Wee. He's just trying to make the move around the 66. Now he's chasing down the leader, Chad Williams.
All right, yellow flag, back it down.
Caution's
out.
Caution out.
And it's going to be Groms in 8th position back here, guys. It's going to be Nick Groms bringing this caution out. As getting rolled up on my screen here. And, he's duking it out with the apron line down here. He gets he comes off of turn four, crosses that apron line down there. I don't know whether he intended to. He certainly couldn't have been intending a pit stop. He's 150 miles an hour coming through the turn here, but tangles with that apron line down there. Around he goes, takes an e-ticket ride through the grass, gets it wowed up, and it's going to bring caution number five out here at Chicagoland Speedway, guys.
Yeah, guys, no big car pileups yet. Mostly single car spinning by themselves. Just these guys overdriving their cars. They're not quite comfortable with it. I mean, these guys probably could have put another few hours of practice and wrench time in these cars. I mean, we're seeing the lack of preparation start to show for some of these guys, but you got like people like Chad Williams, Patrick McElwee, and Jeff Ward up front all night being our top performers so far.
You bet. And, you know, like I said, practice makes perfect. Especially at a track like Chicago. I mean, this is the kind of track that I'm going to spend quite a few laps in the car.
Pits are open for the
you know, and learn what my car is going to be able to do. I'm going to try, the different racing grooves here. There are several here at Chicagoland. I want to find out what this car is going to be capable of doing, so I know, what limits, where to stay, rather than try to push it that extra little notch. I'll know what it can do and what it can't do, but they're coming down pit road.
JD, they're all coming down. Like you said, Chad Williams leading them down. Four tires of fuel for that machine, and they're actually throwing some wedge in the back of it. So you're hearing on a lot of cars, a lot of drivers really upset, saying it's really getting loose. And the longer they go, it's getting even worse. One of the guys in the back that you guys talk about people overdriving it, one of the guys in the back that is not overdriving it will be that number seven machine. I believe it's the number seven machine, yes, of Jesse Richardson. He's been riding around 11th position, maybe in the top 10, and I believe he has quite a bit of damage, and they are not able to make up a whole lot of spots, so he's driving it for everything he's got, and he cannot overdrive it.
All right, good call down on pit road. So this is caution number five here tonight at Chicagoland Speedway. Why don't we go ahead and step away? We'll take a commercial break. You're watching live, ATV Live, Cowboy, so don't wander off. We'll be right back. And we are back live here at Chicagoland Speedway. I want to say good evening to Slammy's wife, Kyle Young, in the house, and BD Ward. What is that? BDG Mike. Oh, that's Mike Ward. Mike, how come you're not on the track here, Cowboy? Mike Ward. I believe that's. I think that's a brother.
Okay, we're going
if I'm
back
mistaken.
To the ring. Stand by.
Father, the father of Jeff Ward, I'm being told. So, Mike Ward watching his grown son out here on a computer game. Oh, Mike Ward's on vacation. I see. I got you. All right. Then working our fifth caution here tonight, guys. Came back on lap 45, the 82 machine of Nick Gomes, having a difficult time. Got caught up with that apron line down there. Went for an e-ticket ride through the grass and wound up bringing out the caution. So Chad Williams, he'll pick up the green flag here tonight this time. I believe that's his first one for tonight. Jeff Ward, your pole sitter, who's kind of been hanging out up here in front. You know, he showed some potential there on that qualifying lap with a 30.499 to Warren's 527. So I'm thinking that Jeff Ward might have been the class act here tonight. And you go down through the statistics, guys. Jeff Ward's actually cleaning the house around here. He's number one in the points. 8 wins, 5 top 5s, 10 top 10 finishes here with Bigdawgz Gaming. So Jeff Ward, he just might be kind of cruising here for a little bit.
Green
flag is out, and we are back to chasing each other around Chicagoland Speedway.
Yeah, it looks like the 89 might be on his tires a little bit on that restart, getting a bump from the 66 Gary Warren. Gary Warren looking on that higher line, one of those two distinctive grooves JD's always talking about. 66 going to get a little bit of a run going down the back stretch on Jeff Ward. Nothing he can do with it.
You bet this time around will take us to the halfway point when they cross the start finish line. And I've seen some unusual, actually some really unusual driving styles here tonight. Usually you see, you know, people, you know, with a driving line that they stay pretty consistent, but seeing a lot of inconsistency here, which tells me that, you know, with these loose conditions, Dakota talking about a lot of these guys putting some extra wedge in their cars, tightening these things up, they're looking. They're hunting around. They're looking for, you know, the quickest way around here without upsetting a car, Matt. So, you know, because one lap they'll take it on the bottom. Another lap they'll take it in the middle. They'll try the top lane out. I think they're just looking for that sweet spot.
I mean, I'm watching Chad Williams here, and I think he's got it mostly figured out. I mean, he's one that's not taking a specific line. We see him go in on that apron, mostly slide it up all the way up to that wall, getting it out there, and I mean, he's been pretty stable doing that all night, but not the quickest.
You bet. He's getting the pressure from Gary Warren down here on the bottom, and there you saw the 31 making that outside lane work for him. He was first across the line, but Warren is still there going into turn one. And this is the trick spot right here. The 31 car is going to have to really get off the throttle to keep it off that wall, as Gary Warren's going to come and take the position that's going to move actually Chad Williams back a couple of notches here. Jeff Ward following Warren right on through. So move Chad Williams back one, Ward up one, and Warren up one. Lee Dietz back here in fourth position at 83 machine. He's still got it on cruise control as well. He's been staying out of trouble pretty much the whole entire night, and that's the key here. Run a solid line. Only do what your car can do. Don't push it beyond its limits here at Chicagoland, because it will come and bite you, as we've seen already. 5 cautions here at Chicagoland in the first 50 laps. So, you know, and every single one of them have been the back end coming around on these guys just fighting a loose car. So, you know, again, stay within the limits, guys. 54 laps in the books here, and we're finally on the downhill side.
Yeah, the last time by, I was saying how that 31 goes into the corner is really slick on the apron. I mean, he's back in third because he got down there too low, nicked the apron, put himself all the way up towards the wall, just barely saving the car from slamming into it. Oh, and it looks like in second place that number 89, Jeff Ward, getting loose, coming off of 4, got on the gas a little too hard. And your leader, Gary Warren, just pulling out. He's up by about half a second right now. He's dominating the field.
Bad, and you're riding along with Jeff Ward in the cockpit there of that 89 car as it goes down the backstretch. You can see Gary Warren out there in front, so it's just a matter of chasing down that 66 machine out there in front. And Now there's what we were talking about pre-race. Jeff Ward making use of that space between the white line and the grass. That's dangerous territory down. Oh, as our leader Warren spins it out, coming off of turn two. Gary Warren spinning it, losing it off of turn two, guys. Your leader comes through the turn. I'm going to roll it up here. Takes the turn. He's up in that center lane there. Been making it work. Back end breaks loose. Around he goes, hard into the outside wall, right at the safer barrier. But he takes a couple of pieces of souvenir off the wall just past that safer barrier as well. So Gary Warren, who has been fighting to stay up in front all night long, finally tangles with a wall here at Chicagoland Speedway. So that's going to bring caution number six out here tonight, guys.
Yeah, JD, he was flirting with that sliding line up towards the wall. It looks like he just realized he was sliding up too quick, tried to correct him, put that car around. I mean, that's what it looked like to me. He's adding a little bit more work for those paint guys to get this track ready for our broadcast tomorrow night, but I'm sure they won't mind pulling an all-nighter.
You bet. I'll tell you what, let's see, the 74 car twice, the 7 is taking a souvenir home, so is the 27,
the lead car's on.
The 82's lead got a couple of souvenirs on. Sitting on the seat, and now the 66 car, so, all right, pit road is going to be open this time by, as Jeff Ward brings them all down pit road, Chad Williams staying right on the bumper of that 89 car all the way down pit road here. And that's the trick here, Dakota. Get in, get out, and do it quick.
Yeah, it's just like before. Everybody coming down, getting four tires and fuel, and several changes I'm hearing because these things are just loose. Jeff Ward seeming to be one of the faster guys on the track, and he definitely has a handle on the car. Very happy with it. He's telling the crew chief everybody's complaining. They wish they could do what he could do. And another guy trying to get some TV time right now, Jesse Richardson, stayed out in the number 7. He has damage and was a little off the pace, I do believe, so he will probably come in next time by. And also, I believe Nick Rooms has also picked up the lucky dog. It's now on the lead lap.
You bet. And Jeff Ward beats them all off pit road, but I think it looks like Dietz had a pretty good run off pit road there, too. Quick pit stop for that 83 car. So, six caution coming out here at Chicagoland Speedway. Want to go ahead and step away. We'll take a commercial break. You're watching live ETV Live, ETV Live Radio, so don't wander off. We'll be right back. Back live here at Chicagoland Speedway with Bigdawgz Gaming. Bigdawgz racing here tonight. And, you know, Chad Williams, he's going to restart here in fourth. He's been playing around with the front row up there this last, probably the last 10 or 15 laps here. Actually, from the last couple of cautions. Chad, pretty impressive record here. 14 top 5 finishes, so it's no wonder he's been kind of in and out of that top five here all night long. Jeff Ward, he's coming in tonight with 8 wins and 5 top five. Those 8 wins might be eating him up here tonight. He just, he's either laying back and just checking things out, or he's having a difficult time putting that 89 car right out in front and keeping it there. He qualified on the pole here tonight. But track temperature is 91 degrees, guys. The ambient temperature hovering right around the 80 degree mark.
Okay, so, we're going back to green.
Track temperature coming up here, Matt. Got to be affecting the tires, the grip. We've been watching loose cars here all night long. And, then, you know, crew chiefs trying to get tightened up down there on pit road. And Jesse Richardson taking a real risk out here this time around, staying out there on the old tires in that 7 machine.
Yeah, and I'm really confused right now, JD, Jesse Richardson staying out with that damaged race car. I think he's just going to be either a rolling roadblock or maybe Nelson Rodriguez is in the best place to be.
You know, rolling roadblock. Yeah, I'm not, you know, I don't know what the strategy is there unless it's bonus points. Pick up, you know, whatever you need to do for bonus points here in the series. But, I tell you, to be out front in that damaged car, either look for him to stay up on the top side as they take the green flag, let him go by him on the bottom, which would probably be the thing to do. But we'll see what happens here as we come to the green flag. Now, Jesse Richardson sits third in the points. He's up a notch this week, too. Second place finish at Richmond last week as the pace car pulls off.
Green
flag racing here at Chicagoland Speedway. And he gets a pretty decent jump. Of course, I don't know if Ward is just being careful or not, but Richardson staying up on that high side as Ward comes alongside on turn one. Out of turn two, it's going to be Jeff Ward to the front and Deets right behind him on their way through.
A little bit of a connection error for Chad Williams right there, but it looks like he's back up front, fighting for the in the lead, actually. I'm trying to get my telemetry all set up after he blinks out right there. Yep, Chad Williams in the lead after that restart, followed by Jeff Ward in second. Ward looks like he's got nothing for him right now. Ward might be just trying to set in his groove, save those tires, hoping for finally to get a long run at this race.
Yeah, and that putting Chad Williams up in the front, some kind of a little deal happened there. I think they call that a, what they call that, a punt? Punt to the front?
Yeah, JD, I mean, I didn't really see that. Like I said, I thought he was going to be gone for a second there and appeared back up on the back stretch, but it looks like Jeff Ward staying right with him, those two cars pulling out by almost a second over the rest of the field. You got Lee Ditz back there in third, having a good race, solid race. He's always been up here in the top three, flirting with it. Back and forth, you got McElwee flirting with the top row. He's led a few laps here tonight, being a strong competitor. Then you got Scott Saul looking to pick up some points. I believe he's back in seventh place in points right now, 174 points behind. But he's out here having fun, trying to get himself a top five tonight.
You bet, and you know, I think these they've been averaging about 10 laps in between the pit stops here. Of course, we had that one on lap 28, and then another one not until lap 45. So, looking for some significant tire wear after about 10 or 12 laps here, guys. So, 64 laps in the books here. We're on the short side of things here at Chicagoland Speedway, with Chad Williams, who kind of too wide for the lead up here is right. Chad Williams for the to the front here. Chad Williams giving it up to Jeff Ward. My bad, Jeff Ward up on the outside in that 89 machine. As we go side by side here with the 31 and the 89 car coming down the front stretch here, past the start finish line, the 89 looks like he's going to get there first. Jeff Ward scores another lap here, still side-by-side going into turn one. 89 car is going to have to get off the throttle. We've seen this all night long. Williams will probably pick it up as the 89 stays in the gas, still side-by-side coming down the backstretch.
Quickly closing in on them, that 83 of Lee Ditz. They're sighting side-by-side, throwing up some pretty slow lap times. 89 of Jeff Ward on that high side getting the run. It looks like he may be able to clear him this time. He does clear him going into one. Chad Williams back on that bottom, trying to get a run coming out of two here. He's got the lead going through the center. Clears him off of two. It looks like Jeff Ward's going to try and get that run down the back stretch, maybe make a move on the low line into three.
Tell you what, Ward having to give it up coming off of turn one, you can only do that a couple of times. How far do you trust your tires anyway? Ward having to get off the throttle there as Williams comes by him right there off of turns one and two. But I'll tell you, Dietz sitting back here in the catbird seat, guys, in that third position in that 83 machine. He's watching these guys duke it out up here, and he's thinking, okay, Cowboys, it'll be my turn here when you boys get done playing around and wearing out your tires. So Lee Dietz just kind of hanging with them right here as they're still side by side for the lead.
Yeah, and I mean, they switched lanes now going into turn one. Are we going to see something different here? You got Chad Williams on that high side, Jeff Ward on the bottom. Equal going into the turn. It looks like Chad Williams has a little bit of a better run through the center. He'll have the run down the back straightaway. They'll stay even side by side.
Yeah, and then typically going through three and four here, the guy on the top can usually stay in the throttle a little bit longer here, Matt. However, the guy on the bottom, because of the tighter radius, has to get off the throttle a little bit longer. So usually you see one of them backing up a little bit, and then you got to make it up on the front stretch. That's exactly what we're seeing here right now. Ward slipping back here just a couple of notches. Dietz up on the outside now. Oh, Williams takes it too wide. Has to get way off the throttle. That puts Ward alongside for the lead.
Yeah, we did start in three
wide. Oh, here we go.
89 on the bottom, 83 in the middle, 31. So getting that run on the high side. Chad Williams pulling it back out. And I mean that Lee Dietz, I mean, he doesn't care. He's trying to put his nose in there three wide right now, and there's not really a spot for him.
You bet. 29 laps left in the books here at Chicagoland Speedway. And the 89 machine, or the 83 machine of Lee Dietz coming alive here, Cowboy. But Ward and Williams still duking it out as Ward comes along and gets positioned off of Dietz. Dietz staying up here on this top side, making it work through turns three and four, coming back down on the front stretch. Ward on the bottom back here, and the 21 car in fourth position back here, Patrick McGilwee, now it's his turn. He's looking out the windshield watching these three go at it, and he's thinking, okay, when you boys get done, it'll be my turn, as he pulls right up to the bumper of Jeff Ward on the bottom, the 83, trying to figure out what that 31 is gonna do on the top, is we got a four-way battle happening up here in the front row.
My biggest worry right now, JD, is that 83 trying to poke his nose in there. If he doesn't realize he's got that 21 and Patrick McGilwee right below him, he might just run right into his door.
You bet. And I'll tell you what, there is just absolutely no quit in these four guys up here. 21 cars backing off here just a notch. Probably a good thing is that Dietz still looking between the 31 and the 89 here on the bottom, three wide possibly. Ain't going to happen here, Cowboy. Dietz is going to get to position on both of them if he keeps his foot in the throttle off of turn four. Ward heavy on the gas coming out of the turn. He's going to hang on to the lead, but put Dietz in second across the start-finish line. That's going to move Patrick McGilwee up one notch. Chad Williams drifting back to fourth. I'll tell you what, these guys are just absolutely on the go here. 74 in the books, 100 laps on the board here tonight. So we are on the short end of the stick here. Matthew, close.
Yeah, coming down into these closing laps, these guys really revving it up. But I'm sure, I believe from what Dakota was telling us earlier, we have to make one more stop, maybe two, coming to these few closing laps. Expect those to be coming up soon. It's been a while since our last caution, but it looks like these guys have worn out their tires a little bit. They're single file, dropping back and splitting up a little bit.
Bet last caution was about 18 laps ago, and this is about time we start seeing really loose conditions here at Chicagoland. So these guys really duking it out up here in the front, 21 and 83. 21 and 83 now going at it. And now Chad Williams back here in fourth position, guys. Chad Williams, that 31 machine. Now it's his turn to keep an eye on those guys out in front. Now, let's take it back to fifth position. Nick Gromes, remember, he had some issues back here a little while. I believe he was if I'm not mistaken, I think he was involved in a caution back on lap 45, but able to hang out here up here in the top five so far. So Nick Groms with a possible top five finish here at Chicagoland here tonight. Sixth position, Scott Zoll, he's still kind of hanging out back here just outside the top five. He's about five or six car lengths off of Groms up there in the front. And of course, Gary Warren, who's had his difficulties, 66 machine, he's the one that brought out that last caution on lap 57 here at Chicago. So we're doing everything he can just to keep the four wheels on the track and the nose pointed in the right direction. But the battle happening out here in front, guys, as Wilson takes a ride down on the bottom of the apron here. Gary Wilson back here in 11th position. Not sure what he's doing. He's really off the pace here, one lap down. So if we do get a caution within the 10-lap limit before the end of this thing, he may be getting a lucky dog, get back on the lead lap. But Wilson with obvious problems here at Chicago tonight.
Actually, JD, I'm looking over here at the chat, and now it looks like Gary Wilson has actually gone and made his pit stop. Now we've got Jesse Richardson down on pit road in that number 7 machine. We saw him stay out on that last caution. But back up front, we got to look again because they're battling side by side. Miguel, we look into that inside of the number 89 of Jeff Ward as they're heading into 3.
Right on the bumper of that 89 machine, Patrick Miguel, we staying right with them. And these guys have been duking it out back and forth and back and forth. Dietz, however, is in third position at 83 car. He's had to back it off quite a bit here. I got to think with about 20 laps since that last pit stop, got to think that Dietz is probably feeling the pain of some half-wore-out tires here on that machine. 20 laps to go here at Chicagoland Speedway, and I do believe they have at least one more stop to make as Ward jumps off the track, takes his, comes back up into the 21, making contact, 21 hanging out up here, up in front. Ward dipped down across the apron line, trying to make up a couple of tenths, and I told you, you know, during pre-race, that transition back up on the track is a real trick. 21 happened to be there when he come back up. Of course, looked like they traded door handles there for a little bit. All the action happening out in front here tonight with Ward, McKelvey, Dietz. Dietz has been in the picture here the later part of the race here. He came alive about lap 48, 49, just before the halfway point here tonight. So Dietz, who's been on cruise control for the first half of the race, he cut them ponies loose, letting them run here tonight, right now, with 82 laps in the books. Ward and the 21 machine up here have been duking it out here for quite a few laps. Patrick McGelly, he was another one on cruise control, guys. And I tell you what, must have been something on pit road down there, crew chief telling them when to cut the dogs loose. Patrick McElwee hanging out here in the front, trying to keep Jeff Ward at bay.
Yeah, and we might have a caution come out here soon. I saw a tire smoke on the backstretch, and yep, there's a caution. We got to roll back and see who that is.
Oh, Chad Williams going around, guys, and the 7 machine going around at the same time. Don't know if they're related or not, but this is caution number 8, I believe. 31 car goes around by himself. Richardson, Richardson, a victim of the 31 car. We watch it on the Ewine machine here. 31 just losing it coming off the turn. Now he's going to tangle with that outside wall. And then the 7 machine looking for a way around. Williams comes down the track and the 7 tangles with the 31 and goes for a ride through the grass. So Chad Williams and Jesse Richardson tangling here. Coming out of, I believe that was turn 4 if I'm not mistaken. So that's going to bring caution number 8 out here at Chicagoland. Caution number 7, my bad.
Okay, pits are up for all cars. We can pit now.
84 laps in the books here, guys, at Chicagoland.
Yeah, guys, as we come into these closing laps, we got to think that everybody that's on the track right now, coming down, getting four tires, filling that thing up with fuel, and getting ready to go for this final stint, we got to think, are they going to try and save tires at the beginning or go all out like they were the last time those four cars battling for the lead? Really hurt Chad Williams as we saw how far he slid back and ended up crashing his car.
You bet. Coming down pit road, it's going to be a no-brainer, Dakota Irwin. Four tires and a bucket of gas, I'm sure.
Oh, without a doubt. And several guys making changes. A guy that is making no changes to the machine, the 21, Patrick McKelly. You said it. You hit it right on the head. He's good. He's been holding back. The crew chief's been telling him what to do. All they did was add tape the last pit stop just to help him get more speed.
All right, 21 car leaves his pit box, and he's going to make his way back out on the track in that number one spot. But I'm looking, Warren stay out this time around? I'm wondering if the secret car stayed out. Roll backwards here and take another look here. I think the 66 car is staying out, but don't know if that's a very smart thing to do either.
I mean, JD, if he stays out, I don't expect more than what happened to Jesse Richardson there when he did, and he's gonna probably end up pitting before the end of this thing or getting wrecked. It actually looks like he's gonna come down pit road this time by giving those lead cars the opportunity that they need to be out on the front row. Jeff Ward being pristine driver all night, starting on the pole, and he hopes to probably end in first position.
Okay, we're going back to green next time by. Lap cars on the inside.
You bet. And as we watch Gary Warren make his way down pit road, one more time, let's throw a spot out there for the ETV Live radio. If you haven't tuned in yet, if you're into classic rock and roll, AC/DC, Led Zeppelin, The Stones, you name it, cowboy, that's the stuff that I grew up with. Some solid rock and roll on ETV Live Radio. And of course, the simulcast, we're doing one right now. All of our racing broadcasts, broadcast live on the ETV Live Radio. Also have three shows in syndication starting on Monday nights from 6 to 8 p.m. You can join Wesley Outland and Michael Neff for the And the Winner Is Motorsports show. All your local dirt track action from around the country. And then, of course, on Tuesday night at 9:30 p.m., Open Paddock Live with Sean Peachin, Jay Douglas Patterson, and Mike Witzel. I'll tell you, if you're into open wheel, American Open Wheel Series, a little bit of European F1 stuff thrown in there in the mix, I'll tell you what, you got to catch these guys. Motorsports in Brief, the Mazda Indy, Road to Indy, some good stuff happening at 9:30 on Tuesday nights with Open Paddock Live. And then, of course, on Friday night, the Pit Report with J.D. Webb and Dakota Irwin. And I'll tell you what, Dakota, he'll be calling the shots tomorrow night from 7 to 8, 10 p.m. just before the Friday night showdown, all live on
Green
Radio as we go green. Patrick McKelly is still hanging out in the front row up here, but I tell you what, being run down by Jeff Ward as we get close to the end of this thing. Ward, Ward's been sent second seat here to a couple of guys. This is the first time he's sent second seat to Patrick McKelly, though. Chad Williams has been out there in front. Gary Warren, that 66 car, he's been occupying that front row for a little bit. Warren fighting back here in sixth position on top side here. He's going to go past the, I believe that's the 27 car down there. Of course, 27 car, all kinds of damage. Gary Wilson. Wilson involved in that caution back on lap 19. Significant damage to his machine.
Yeah, looking at number 21 of Patrick McGalloway out front. Looks like he's not even being fought. They're both on cruise control. Jeff Ward kind of just stalking him out. He's got 10 laps to make his next time by. And we're on the 11 to go right now. And they're just both cruising it out. As I'm looking back, I believe in the third position, that's Lee Ditz on the outside. On the bottom, Nick Gromes. Nick Gromes trying to make that pass for third place, get himself a podium finish.
You bet, Nick Gromes. and Dietz duking it out here, guys, for position. In fact, Dietz is going to get a couple across the line. Of course, he had the faster line coming on that top line off of turn 3 and 4. Down into turn 1 here. He's going to stay in that center lane all the way through here with Gromes on the bottom, that 87 car. 83 car gets a good run coming off that off the top there. Gromes still can't get the can't have the horsepower to get there, but tell you what, right on the bumper into 3 and 4 here as they come off, as Deitch takes right up to the wall a little bit, but to Gromes, just not enough horsepower to get there. In the meantime, Chad Williams back here, 6th position, at 31 machine, alongside the 66. As the 66 gets positioned, swings up high in turn 1, that's going to put Chad Williams on the bottom, and just gets a little bit of wheel coming off of 2. Chad Williams looking to put that machine his back out in front, currently sitting outside the top 5 and 6.
Bringing you guys back to last week, Jeff Ward, not unfamiliar to victory lane as he won last week at Richmond. He's your points leader currently. He's going to pick a few more points up over second place. Second place, Chad Williams, who is 22 points back. I believe the way they stand right now, he'll be about 20, correct me if I'm wrong, JD, with their point system, but he'll be about 26 to 28 points back at the end of this race if they stay where they are.
I believe you're right, and I believe you're absolutely right that Chad Williams needs a good position. He needs to finish at 1 or 2 tonight to really gain on Jeff Ward if Ward can stay up there. But Chad Williams, like I say, sitting second in the points. Top 5 finish in Richmond last week, but Williams certainly off the pace right now. But Williams involved in that last caution with the 7 car back on lap 84. So pretty much a no-brainer out here in front. Patrick McElwee doing a good job of hanging on to that lead. 6 laps to left here at Chicagoland. And Jeff Ward probably getting instructions from his crew chief. Keep them ponies woed up here just a little tiny bit. Just a little bit more here before we turn them loose. Of course, Dietz, who was a possible threat to lead up here, significantly off the pace. In fact, let's put Lee Dietz in an 83 car almost 3 seconds off the pace behind the leaders. Nick Gromes, Chad Williams running about 3.5 seconds off the pace.
Right,
but, the caution comes out. The 31 involved, guys.
Okay,
31 car bringing that caution out.
Pit road's closed.
Don't know if he had any help. Roll it back here on the rewind. Williams coming through, looks like turn 4 here. Warren behind him. Williams out in front. Oh! The 31 car gets the bumper from the 66 car. You watch him drop down into the turn here, and the 66 is going to put the bumper to the 31, and that's going to bring caution number 8 out here at Chicagoland.
Yeah, and even after he spins him, JD, that 66 gives him the bumper again. 66 just trying to avoid it that time, but 31 slides right up in front of him, and that 66 ends up booting him back into the wall.
And then, wow, what a night here. Chad Williams having a tough night here at Chicagoland, staying up in front for the most part all night long, gets into trouble. Actually, he started having problems here right around around lap 80 or so, but wound up tangling with the 7 machine back on lap 84. And, of course, now trying to get that machine of his move forward, tangles with the 66. That'll set him back here a little bit, too. With 4 laps to go here at Chicago on Speedway.
Okay, pits are up for all cars. We can pit now.
Pit road is open this time. Will there be any takers? Let's keep an eye on the entrance here. And this is one of those calls as Jeff Ward comes down pit road. Oh, he fakes it out. Gonna stay out. He saw the 21 car staying on pit road. 21 car, his decision was made a long time ago as he stayed in that upper lane. Ward making the fake for Lee Dietz to go down pit road, but Dietz have nothing of that, cowboy. I'm going to stay right here with you. So it was kind of a no-brainer there for everybody else. Ward trying to fake him out, Matt. Nobody took it.
Yeah, and it looks like nobody that's really going to be a competitor here tonight did pit. I'm thinking that 83 Lee Dates might have something for these guys up front, but he slid back so far. He was able to hang with them earlier on, but as it got later in the run, he just wasn't as strong. I think he can pick a podium finish tonight over Nick Groams. Nick Groams really going to be hunting him down, though.
All right, and I tell you, we're getting down the wire here. I think it's going to be one of those green-white checkered type of finishes here at Chicagoland, guys, with 97 on the board. I believe next time around they're going to add one more. So we may wind up with a green-white checkered run here at Chicagoland Speedway with Bigdawgz Racing. Bigdawgzgaming.com. And they're into a lot more than just as racing stuff. They do some of them first-person, second-, third-person, whatever shooter games. But Pace Car is pulling off. We're going to get set to wrap this one up, Cowboy. Patrick McKilley's going to pick it up, and this is a green-white checkered. Jeff Ward on
green, black, go.
Over here on the get-go. The green is out. Ward chasing down McKilley. Dietz right there trying to hang with him in third. We'll keep an eye on this front row up here. The 87 machine. At Nick Groams looking on the bottom of the 83 for position here, and staying right side by side, but up in front, Jeff Ward, Patrick McKilley, and looks like McKilley's going to get it going into turn three.
Yeah, Williams looking for those back-to-back, or not Williams, but Jeff Ward looking for that back-to-back win, taking lap 99 this time by two to go. He's got the inside line, and Patrick McKilley's going to have that run down the backstretch, but Jeff Ward on that inside, maybe he'll be able to slide up in front.
And this is the white flag lap, guys. When they cross the start-finish line, game over, Cowboy. Jeff Ward on the bottom, 21 up on the outside. Patrick McKilley, who came alive, second half of the race, going to give it up on the bottom of turn four here. Jeff Ward slides up. McKilley on the bottom to the start-finish line, all the way across the apron. Jeff Ward is going to pick it up by 13 thousandths of a second over the 21 machine of Patrick McKilley. Lee Dietz with a solid 3/10 of a finish right behind him in third place. So Jeff Ward, Patrick McKilley, Lee Dietz, your top three. Nick Groams with a very respectable fourth place finish. Gary Warren in that 66 car with a top five. What a night here at Chicagoland Speedway. And sadly, Chad Williams, who had a strong car all night, in and out of the top five all night long, had the lead for a while, led a few laps. He's going to finish outside the top five here at Chicagoland Speedway. That 31 car, of course, involved in the last couple of cautions here at the end of the race. But I tell you, Jeff Ward picking up another trophy here at Bigdawgz Racing. As we watch Jeff Ward burn what's left of the rubber off them hot tires on the start-finish line, I'm sure here for just a couple of minutes, we're going to go ahead and step away, take a commercial break. When we come back, the post-race show here for Chicagoland Speedway with Bigdawgz Racing. So don't wander off. We'll be right back.
Nice win, Jeff.
All right, and we are back live here at Chicagoland Speedway, and what a night. 100 laps later, I tell you what, we saw some guys duking it out here real early in the game. We saw a few with the cruise control pushed, but let's take it down to Victory Circle, standing down here with Jeff Ward. Jeff Ward picking up, I believe, your 9th trophy of the season here from Chicagoland Speedway. Tell me about your race, bud.
Yeah, that was a pretty awesome race there. I'm glad we was able to get it there. I was really close with Patrick. Came right down to the wire. I think that's happened a couple times with me and him this year. So, it was really fun. There's a couple fast guys out there that had trouble. If not for that, it might have definitely been somebody else in victory lane. But all in all, a great night. It was a fun racetrack. A lot of side-by-side racing.
You know, we saw some loose conditions out there with several of the cars. Of course, a lot of the cautions tonight, you know, the back end's just coming around on the cars. What was your crew chief telling you about taking care of your car here tonight?
Well, it just seemed like, you know, after about 6 or 8 laps, when you got in the center and got back on the gas, and wanted to step out. So I just tried to stay right down on the white line there, and seemed to help my car. If I got up in the middle or the top too high, I'd definitely start to lose it. So, just tried to keep it straight. I know it was pretty slick out there, so glad we could keep from spinning it out.
All right. Well, that's going to be pole number 10, win number 9 here with Bigdawgz Racing. Who made it happen for you, Jeff?
Yeah, I definitely want to thank my teammates, Dwayne Hamm and Mike Ward. My dad couldn't be here tonight. He's actually down in Panama City. So I'd like to thank him. Thank Chad for adminning tonight. Like to thank you guys for doing the broadcast. And we're actually lucky enough to have you all again next race, so that'll be cool. Just thank everybody that helps out.
You bet. And Jeff, Dad's watching. He's been watching all night. He's logged into the chat room over there. But congratulations, picking up another trophy here, Chicagoland Speedway, another one for the trophy shelf. Let's throw it on down pit road here a little bit. I believe Matthew Close has caught up with our second place finisher, Patrick McElwee.
Hey, Patrick, and you had a great race today. We thought you were going to win up front strong. What happened those closing laps? What was going through your mind?
Well, I know Jeff's probably the best on restarts, and that's where I've always struggled. But I figured after I got through the first lap, it would be all right. But he just got his nose right under me and coming off a 4. And I'm like, well, here it goes. So I just piled it in as hard as I could into 1. And it stuck in 1, but it didn't stick in 3. So
we had a lot of cars going around loose tonight. Did you have any problem with that? I mean, how did you keep your car under control from sliding out on you?
Well, I found that it was just a lot of people were just using up their tires, so I just started after I got set back in the pack from lap 30, I just started riding around, just riding behind Lee for a lot of the race, and then once everybody just used up their tires, just start putting the hammer down, and it would be a little bit loose, but could always catch it. So, I don't know, I guess I was having fewer problems than everybody else today.
All right, well, congratulations on your second place finish. Is there anybody out there you'd like to thank tonight?
Yeah, Bigdawgz. Putting this on for all of us. I wouldn't be racing if it wasn't for them, so thanks.
Okay, guys, and I think I'll send it over to Dakota, who's caught up with our third place finish here.
Yeah, Mr. Dietz, driver of the number 83 machine. How'd you do it, bud? I remember them talking about you in the booth. You were a little ways in the back, just kind of riding around by yourself, and then we started hearing a lot about you. You're running up front, you're running down the leader, you're racing for the lead, and you get kind of quiet at the end. How'd you do it, bud?
Yeah, I missed qualifying, had to start in the back, and just took care of my stuff, man, and a lot of spins, a lot of cautions, and I tried to stay out of that mess. Avoided one very narrowly, but my crew chief told me just to back it up into corners and ease on the throttle, and that helped me out a lot.
Yeah, it sure looked like it, man. I mean, you were one of the cars to beat out there definitely tonight. And, I know everybody's saying it was real loose. How was it for you when you started listening to your crew chief back up the corner and you seemed to be fast?
I spun it in practice one time, and that's when the crew chief told me to back it up, and I backed it up and eased on the throttle going in. Stayed down low, like Jeff mentioned, stay down low to that white line, and it didn't give me no problems. And I tell you what, I had a blast racing with Jeff and Pat and Chad up front there. That was just awesome.
And who makes it happen for you tonight, bud?
Oh, hey, my wife makes me happen, and Bigdawgz is awesome. I love this racing league.
All right, well, there you have it from your third place finisher back up to the booth with J.D. Webb.
All right. Hey, the wives play an important part of a man's hobby, don't they? I'll tell you what, good stuff there, Cowboy. Hey, Chicagoland Speedway, Matthew Close, 100 laps later, 8 cautions, a lot of loose conditions out there, but we saw some pretty impressive driving at the same time. And a lot of these guys suffering from those cautions, fighting back. They're all champions, but tough night here at Chicago.
Yeah, tough night indeed, and I mean, it was great to see these guys go out there and run their car as hard as they can before they'd slide out, JD, and I hope maybe see some racing like this all weekend at Chicago.
You bet, and of course, John Wessling on the camera tonight, he's staying over at that Ritz-Carlton while the rest of us got this little flea-ridden, flea-bag motel down here in Chicagoland Speedway. We're here for the whole entire week, Cowboy. Tomorrow night, Friday night showdown, 8:20 p.m., you can join Mike Conti and company for the Friday Night Showdown race.
Hey, waiter, send me that caviar. What? Could you slide that caviar over here?
See what I mean? You know, I mean, come on. But he is the big boss, so I guess he does get the good stuff. But, hey, and then Saturday night, 8 o'clock, Chicagoland Speedway again. This one's for Nuff World, nuffworld.com. I tell you what, 100% race. It's going to be a long day, about 3 or 4 hours there. And then back on Sunday night at about 7:45 p.m., the SEE Elite Pro Series from Chicagoland Speedway has started their chase race on Sunday night. And then, of course, on Monday night, Chicago race, Chicagoland Speedway with Real Sim Racing with the start of their chase. And I'll tell you, just a Chicago, Chicago, Chicago. And, of course, don't miss the pit report tomorrow night with Dakota Ehrman and a whole bunch of guys coming in. Of course, the winner tonight, Jeff Ward, put your email down there in the TeamSpeak box down there. We'll send you an email, and you're welcome to join Dakota Ehrman tomorrow night at 7 o'clock p.m. on the pit report. That's our weekly radio show where we feature all the winners from the week's worth broadcasting here on ETV Live. Don't forget the ETV Live radio simulcast syndicated shows. Check it out, etv-eplay.net. So from Chicagoland Speedway with John the Bad Boy Wessling, Matthew Close, Dakota Ehrman, Jeff Ford, Lee Dietz, and Patrick McElwee, we'll talk to you boys tomorrow night.